All over the metro, the aftershocks continue tonight in the wake of the federal sentencing of Ellense Brooks-Simms. The former school board member has been credited with bringing down one of the most powerful political families in New Orleans. My story is all new at 10.
The full scope of this bribery case could not have been realized had she not come forward when she did and as she did. And that's the absolute truth.
70-year-old Ellense Brooks-Simms could have gone to prison for 5 years, but instead will only serve 18 months.
She knows she's let people down. She knows she let the children of the city down. And the judge properly brought those things up, as did the government. But what distinguished the reason for the lesser sentence was her unique cooperation against the Jefferson organized crime family.
Harsh words from Ralph Capitelli, Brooks-Simms' lawyer, who bristles at any suggestion that his client got off too easy.
That's not just testifying. When somebody's asked to go undercover, especially a woman, against somebody as intimidating as Mose Jefferson, it was very difficult to do. And she did it, and that's what made the case against Mose Jefferson, and I think broke the logjam for a lot of what's happened.
And what's happened to the Jefferson family is stunning. Some of it a confluence of circumstance. Head of the family, former Congressman Bill Jefferson, sentenced to 13 years after being convicted of bribery and racketeering, currently out on appeal. His sister, Betty Jefferson, and her daughter, Angela Coleman, pleaded guilty to using money from charity groups to enrich themselves. And his brother, Mose Jefferson, already convicted and sentenced to 10 years for fraud and obstruction of justice, and still facing trial on the case that Brooks-Simms pleaded guilty to. Xavier University professor Dr. Silas Lee says it was Brooks-Simms who put the final nail in the Jefferson family political coffin.
But yeah, two separate investigations. This one was the corruption investigation involving the school board. And then you had the investigation of former Congressman Bill Jefferson. So you had two separate investigations that almost served as a perfect storm in terms of coming together at close points in time to impact and bring down the political influence of the Jefferson family.
Brooks-Simms, he says, was obviously a member of the inner circle.
By having all of this critical insider information that they would have never had access to, that becomes the critical link in terms of the federal government putting the pieces of the puzzle together.
Brooks-Simms has been ordered to surrender to federal authorities by May 10th. Mose Jefferson, already sentenced to 10 years behind bars in a prior case, is awaiting trial on a second case where, ironically, his own sister and niece could end up testifying against him.